In this lecture, I would like to discuss about osmosis and osmotic pressure. The topic is osmosis and osmotic pressure. So what is osmosis? Osmosis is a spontaneous process by which flow of the solvent takes place towards the solution. Flow of the solvent takes place toward the solution. From dilute solution to the concentrated solution through semi-permeable membrane. Osmosis is a spontaneous process by which flow of the solvent takes place towards the solution from a dilute solution to the concentrated solution through a semi-permeable membrane. So let us show this by this diagram. Osmosis, this is the diagram belong to the osmosis process. So in one compartment we have to take the solvent and in another compartment we have to take the solution. Suppose that is a sodium chloride solution. And it is separated by this semi-permeable membrane. In this case, what is the role of the semi-permeable membrane? Semi-permeable membrane is allowed to pass only the solvent molecules. Semi-permeable membrane, it is allowed to pass only the solvent molecules to pass from one side to the other side. Okay. Generally, solute molecules cannot be transferred through this semi-permeable membrane. So suppose we take water here and we take solution of sodium chloride in water. So you can see here, the solvent molecules are moving from this side to this side. Okay. That process, it is called as a osmosis process, flow of the solvent. You can take another example in case of plants. Okay. The solvent, that is water, going from downward to the upward direction. That is also the osmosis process. Okay. The solvent molecule, it is moving from downward to the upward direction. And this osmosis process, it is a spontaneous process. And in this process, flow of the solvent molecule takes place toward the solution. Or the dilute solution is moving towards the concentrated solution. Suppose that here dilute solution is there, here a concentrated solution is there. So dilute solution, it is flowing from this side to this side. Okay, so this is the osmosis process. Now let us see what is a osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure. So osmotic pressure can be defined as, osmotic pressure, it is defined as the minimum pressure to be exerted onto the solution to stop the flow of the osmosis when separated from the solvent by semi-permeable membrane. So osmotic pressure, it is applicable onto the solution side, this. Okay, so we have to apply here the osmotic pressure. It is denoted by the letter pi, osmotic pressure pi. So when we apply the osmotic pressure here onto the solution side, then the solvent molecules cannot be moving from this side to this side. It means the osmosis process, it is opposite. When we apply the osmotic pressure on this side. So when we apply the pressure here, the flow of the solvent from this side to this side does not take place. Okay. So the minimum pressure to be exerted on the solution to stop the flow of the osmosis when separated by the semi-permeable membrane. So this is the semi-permeable membrane here. So the solvent molecules and solution are separated by this semi-permeable membrane. And when we apply the pressure here, osmotic pressure, then the flow of the solvent does not take place. So that minimum pressure to be exerted on the solution to stop the flow of the osmosis flow of the solvent, it is called as a osmotic pressure. Okay, you can see this diagram also. Another example, sugar molecules are here and water molecules are here. This is a diluted sugar solution and this is concentrated sugar solution, and this is semi-permeable membrane. So in general, in osmosis process, what happens? From this diluted compartment, the water molecules are moving from this side to this side. So you can see here, the water molecules are moving from this side to this side. So this level will be increases here, and this level will be decreases here. More water is drawn into the concentrated solution. So water is moving from this side to this side. That is the osmosis process. Okay. So this is the osmosis process, but to study the process, we require here the semi-permeable membrane, and through that semi-permeable membrane, the molecules are moving, solvent molecules are moving from one side to the other side. So related to this now, osmosis, osmotic pressure, let us going to be discuss this topic, von Tops osmotic laws and von Tops equation. In 11th standard, you studied the Boyle's law and Char's law. Okay, in that similar way, this von Tops osmotic laws and von Tops equation we are going to be discussed now here. First of all, let us see the von Tops osmotic laws. These are related to the osmosis process. Once again, I would like to discuss here the osmosis process. So you can see here, in the osmosis process, suppose we have a solution and solvent molecules, and this is the semi-permeable membrane. Okay, now here water molecules are there. Water molecules are there, that is solvent. Okay, so this is a solvent, and here solution, that is sodium chloride solution. Sodium chloride solution, this is. So what happens here? The solvent molecules are moving from this side to this side. That process, it is called as a osmosis process. Osmosis process. And to stop this osmosis pressure, we have to apply the pressure here, the pressure exerted onto the solution compartment to stop the flow of the solvent from this side to this side. To stop the osmosis process, it is called as the osmotic pressure, and it is denoted by the pi, osmotic pressure. Okay, so let us study now the first law, which is given here, von Tops Boyle's law. Boyle's law has been studied by you in the 11th standard. What is? The pressure is inversely proportional with the volume. The pressure varies inversely with volume at constant temperature. At constant temperature, okay? That is osmotic pressure. It is denoted by the pi. It varies inversely with volume. So 1 upon V. So as the volume is greater, pressure will be less. Suppose that if we the volume is greater here, then the low pressure can be applicable. Okay, if the volume is larger, pressure will be smaller. If the volume is less, pressure will be greater. So osmotic pressure varies inversely with volume at constant temperature. So we can write this pi is proportional to 1 upon V. Therefore, pi into V, it is constant. To remove the proportionality sign, we have to take the constant here. So pi V equal to constant. So this is the von Tops Boyle's law. The pressure varies inversely with volume. Okay. Now second law, it is von Tops Char's law. Okay. So osmotic pressure varies directly with absolute temperature at constant volume. If the volume is constant, so osmotic pressure pi varies directly with temperature. So it means that if the temperature is higher, osmotic pressure will be higher. That is true. Okay, as we increase the temperature here, vapors are formed. So vapor pressure, we have to apply the more pressure. Okay, then that liquid should be remains into the liquid state. So osmotic pressure pi varies with temperature. Okay, at constant volume, volume should be constant here. So you can see pi is proportional to T. So therefore we can write here pi upon T. Taking this T on this side, it is equal to constant. So this is the one top charge law. Osmotic pressure varies directly with temperature. It is directly proportional to the temperature. As the temperature is increases, osmotic pressure it is also increases. And that is the general thing. When we are going to increase the temperature, we have to increase the pressure. Okay, then the system remains as it. Otherwise, due to increase in the temperature, what happens? This is totally converted into the vapor state. But when we are again going to increase the pressure here on the same, on the opposite side, it will remains as it. Okay, so osmotic pressure pi, it is directly proportional to the temperature. And here osmotic pressure pi is inversely proportional with the volume here. So pi V is a constant. This is suppose equation one here. This is second equation. According to this, now we can construct the von Toff's equation. We can write the von Toff's equation now here. So you can see here von Toff equation. So the product pi V upon T. Okay, see now pi V, it is a equal to constant. This is first equation. And this pi upon T, it is a constant. So constant will be same on both sides. So we can write the equation here, the product pi V upon T. It is constant. Okay, as pi V is constant, then pi upon T is constant. Then we can write here, this product pi V upon T is also constant because pi V is constant here. Then pi upon T is also constant. So we can combine these two equations. We can combine these two equations here. Okay. So we can write here pi V upon T, it is equal to constant. The combination of these two equations. Okay. So pi V, it is equal to, suppose constant is R, it is a gas constant, all of us know. So we can write here pi V, it is equal to RT, where R is a constant term. And therefore we can write this equation pi V, it is equal to nRT. Okay, where N, it is a number of moles. And this equation, it is called as a von Toff equation. The product of osmotic pressure multiplied up volume, osmotic pressure and volume, it is equal to number of moles multiplied by this R, that is a gas constant, multiplied by the temperature. Just like the law, which is PV, it is equal to nRT. Okay. But in this case, pi, it is called as a osmotic pressure. That is only the difference here. So in this way, we write here von Toff equation. Okay. On the basis of these laws. Now let us proceed further. The thermodynamic derivation of von Toff's equation. Let us going to derive that von Toff equation now. Thermodynamic derivation of the von Toff equation. So I would like to write here once again the von Toff equation. So von Toff equation pi V equal to nRT. This is the von Toff equation. Pi, it is the osmotic pressure, V is the volume, N is the number of mole, R is the gas constant, and T is the temperature, absolute temperature. Okay. So let us going to derive this equation now. So at equilibrium, chemical potential, all of us know the chemical potential, it is denoted by the letter mu, of the solvent is same on both sides. Okay. In diagram we have shown like this. This is a semi-permeable membrane. In one compartment, there is a solvent. In another compartment, there is a solution. Okay. So solvent is here. okay, and solution is here at equilibrium. Suppose that equilibrium stage is there, chemical potential will be same on both sides. Chemical potential of this solvent, it is equal to the chemical potential of this solvent, okay. So in terms of equation we can write this. Now into the, in the solution compartment there is a osmotic pressure we have to apply. We have to apply the osmotic pressure. So therefore chemical potential of the solvent plus osmotic pressure, in this case it is mu plus pi, because to maintain the equilibrium we have to apply the osmotic pressure here. Then and then the osmosis process will be stopped. So in this case chemical potential of the solvent, it is mu plus pi, mu plus pi at equilibrium LHS. Now that is a solution. And on to the RHS side, or you can now suppose that we if we take the solvent here and if we take the solution here, okay, then here mu plus pi and here only mu, okay, this is solvent, this is solution, because we have written here. So mu of the solvent plus pi, that is LHS solution, left hand side we have take the solution and right hand side mu of the solvent. At equilibrium we can write this equation, mu of the solvent plus pi, it is equal to mu of the solvent pi, it is equal to mu of the solution, okay. So try to understand about this. Now pure solvent is at pressure P. Suppose that the pressure P is existing here in the solvent compartment, okay, and the solution is having the pressure P plus pi. The solution side, it is having the pressure P plus pi, okay, atmospheric pressure is existing there, that is pressure P. So pure solvent is at pressure P on this side. Once again I would like to show this on the another screen here, you can see, okay. So show the osmosis process here, we are going to derive the one top equation, that is pi v equal to nRT. So this is solution side and this is solvent side. And the solvent molecules are moving from this side to this side, and we have to apply the osmotic pressure here, pi, onto the solution compartment. Osmotic pressure pi onto the solution compartment here. Okay. Now at equilibrium, the chemical potential will be same. At equilibrium, chemical potential of solvent. Chemical potential of solvent is same on both sides, okay. So we can write here chemical potential of the LHS compartment, that is mu plus pi, because osmotic pressure is existing there. This is for the solvent, okay, this is for the solution, and it is equal to mu of the solvent. At equilibrium both are same here. Now the external pressure, it is P here. So that external pressure, it is applicable on both sides. So you can see here, pure solvent is at pressure P and solution is at pressure P plus pi. Okay. So chemical potential of solvent at pressure P is mu zero. Mu zero, it is a, because solvent, it is a pure component. So chemical potential of solvent, it is at pressure P is mu zero. Let us assume this. Chemical potential of solvent at pressure P is mu zero, this, okay. Chemical potential of the solvent in the solution compartment is lowered by the solute, that is known to us, because due to the addition of the non-volatile solute, the chemical potential, it is also lowered, okay. You can see here, this is the solution compartment and this is the solvent compartment here, okay. So the chemical potential of the solvent at pressure P is mu zero. That is known to us, at pressure P it is mu zero. Chemical potential of the solvent in the solution is lowered because we are adding the solute here in case of the solution. So chemical potential will be decreases there to some extent because solute is added here. Okay, so chemical potential of the solvent in the solution, it is lowered by the solute, but it is raised due to the greater pressure P plus pi. Pressure is acting here, P plus pi. Okay, and pressure is acting here, P only. So due to that pressure, the chemical potential will be increases. It is raised due to greater pressure P plus pi acting on the solution. Okay, this is the solution compartment, this is the solvent compartment. Pressure, it is here P plus pi. P is the, suppose, external pressure, pi is the osmotic pressure. So external pressure, it is on both solution and solvent compartment. And to prevent the osmosis process, we are applying the osmotic pressure here. Okay, so it is raised due to the greater pressure P plus pi acting on the solution. This potential is denoted by this term, mu of x. Mu x means mole fraction, P plus pi. That is P plus pi, it is a pressure. Okay, this potential chemical, because now it is depends upon what? It is depends upon the mole fraction. It is depend upon the pressure P plus pi. So we can write mu x P plus pi. In this side, the chemical potential, in the solvent side, chemical potential is only mu zero at pressure P. But in the solution side now, there is a solute molecules. So chemical potential, it is depends upon the mole fraction of the solute as well as mole fraction of the solvent. And it is also depends upon the pressure P plus pi, which is acting here onto the solution side. So we can write the chemical potential here, mu x P plus pi, where x is the mole fraction of the solvent. What is x here? Mole fraction of the solvent. So it means that the chemical potential, it will depends upon, because we are talking about the chemical potential of the solvent here. In the solution in the solvent compartment, the chemical potential, it is mu zero. But in the solution compartment now, the chemical potential of the solvent, it is depends upon the mole fraction of the solvent as well as this pressure P plus pi. Okay. So at equilibrium now, we have to mention the equilibrium. Equilibrium, both chemical potentials are same. So this is the chemical potential of the solvent compartment, mu zero P at pressure P. And this is the chemical potential of the solvent at mole fraction of the solvent X, and osmotic pressure, it is P plus pi. Both are same at equilibrium. So we have to write the equation in this way. Okay, so at equilibrium, the chemical potential of the solvent, it is here mu zero, because it is pure. Mu zero means chemical potential of the pure component at pressure P. Pressure P is existing here. And here mu of x P plus pi, that is a mole fraction of the solvent as well as this pressure P plus pi. Now, as per the theory of the chemical potential, if you know this equation, mu equal to mu zero plus RT ln X. This is the equation of the chemical potential. Okay. RT ln X. Actually, the equation will be like this. Mu equal to mu zero plus RT ln A, where A is the activity of the solution. Okay. This equation, it is derived by us in the SY BSc class. Chemical potential, it is related to the standard chemical potential and activity. So in place of activity, we have taken the mole fraction here, because activity, it is directly proportional to the mole fraction. Okay. So mu equal to mu zero plus RT ln X. So you can see now. So mu of the solution compartment, mu X P plus pi, it is equal to mu zero P plus pi plus RT ln X. On the basis of this, now we can write down this equation. OK, this term, I would like to write this. Okay. So in this compartment, that is chemical potential, it is mu x p plus pi. It is equal to mu 0 p plus pi. Okay. Pressure, it is here, p plus pi, it is existing. So mu 0 p plus pi now here. Rt ln x. So we convert this equation to this equation. So we write this term here. Okay. We write this term here for the solution compartment. Okay. Mu of x, mu it is equal to mu 0 plus Rt ln x. And in the solution compartment, it depends upon x and p plus pi. Okay. So try to understand about this. This is the equation one here. So we write this equation one here. Then mu 0 p plus pi, it is equal to, means this mu 0 p plus pi, it is equal to the chemical potential on the solvent side. Okay, so it is equal to, it can be written as, you can see here, mu 0 p plus pi, it is equal to mu 0 p plus v into dp. Okay, this is also the another equation. Chemical potential of the solvent, it is equal to mu 0 plus v dash into dp, where v dash, it is the molar volume of the solvent. V dash, it is called as a molar volume of the solvent. So we can write this equation, mu 0, it is equal to mu 0 p plus v into dp. Or you can say that this osmotic pressure, it is related to this volume, molar volume. Okay, initially we know that osmotic pressure, it is depends upon the volume. Okay, so it is written as v dash into dp. This is the equation 2 here. And from equation 1 and 2, let us see the equation 1 here. Equation 1 should be this. So we can put this value here, mu 0 p plus pi, it is equal to. So from equation 1 and 2, we can write this now equation, minus Rt ln x, it is equal to v dash into dp. We are getting this equation. This v dash into dp, it is equal to minus Rt ln x. By substituting the values here, in this equation, we can substitute the values, then we are getting this equation here. Okay. We have to substitute this value now here, mu 0 p plus pi, it is equal to mu 0 p plus v into dp. Okay, so one of the term get cancelled here, then v into dp is equal to Rt ln x. So by comparing equation 1 and 2, from equation 1 and 2 we are getting this equation now, minus Rt ln x, it is equal to v dash into dp, where v dash is the molar volume. Okay, now p is the pressure and dp is the extra pressure on the solution. Dp is the extra pressure on the solution. What is P? P is the pressure. And dp is the extra pressure on the solution. That is pi. Dp is nothing but pi. Extra pressure we have to apply. Okay. Now, let us simplify this equation now. So, this is now dp, it is pi here. So, we can write here pi into v dash. It is equal to minus Rt ln x. Let us write here this equation, pi into v dash, it is equal to minus Rt ln x. Okay, from this equation 1 and 2, we write this equation, minus Rt ln x, it is equal to v dash into dp. Remember this. Okay, you can do this, compare this equation. Okay, now dp, it is extra pressure, that is osmotic pressure. So we write here pi. So therefore, pi v dash, it is equal to minus Rt ln x, where v dash is the molar volume of the solvent. What is x here? X, it is the mole fraction of the solvent. X is the mole fraction of the solvent. Okay. Mole fraction of the solvent. So it is equal to 1 minus x dash. Suppose that x dash, it is the mole fraction of the solute. Mole fraction of the solute. Because x plus x dash, it is equal to 1. Mole fraction of the solute. Solute plus solvent, it is equal to 1. So x, it is equal to 1 minus x dash, where x dash, it is the mole fraction of the solute. So you can see here pi v dash, it is equal to minus RT ln 1 minus x dash. Okay. But according to this equation ln 1 minus x dash, the log ln 1 minus x dash, it is equal to minus x dash. Logarithmic expansion, we write this equation in the previous also, minus minus x dash square divided by 2 minus x dash cube divided by 3, like that. For a dilute solution, this is these terms are eliminated. So ln 1 minus x dash, it is equal to minus x dash. Okay. So therefore, ln 1 minus x dash, it is equal to minus x dash. This minus minus sign, it is positive here. This is minus x dash. So minus into minus, it is plus. Okay. So we can, you can see here, pi v dash, it is equal to minus RT minus x dash. So it is RT into x dash, pi v dash, it is equal to. So in this way, we can write this equation now. Pi v dash, it is equal to x dash into RT. Okay. What is x dash here? X dash, it is the mole fraction of the solute. X dash, it is a mole fraction of the solute. Then let us see the next term here. Now the mole fraction of the solute x dash, it is equal to number of the solute divided by total number of moles of the solute and the solvent. Okay. Mole fraction of the solute, it is equal to number of moles of the solute divided by number of moles of the solute plus number of moles of the solvent. That is known to us. For a dilute solution, this, if the solution is dilute, number of moles of the solutes are very, very less. Solvent, it is having the major proportion. So this is number of moles of the solute plus solvent, it is equal to number of moles of the solute. Number of moles of the solvent, approximately equal to. Therefore, x dash, it is equal to number of moles of the solute divided by number of moles of the solvent. So put into that equation, pi v dash equal to RT into x dash. So x dash is number of moles of the solute divided by number of moles of the solvent. So we are getting this equation here. Okay. So we substitute x dash into this. Now you can see here, pi v dash into this multiplied by number of moles of the solvent, it is equal to nRT. Number of moles of the solute, nRT. Now the final equation, it is pi v equal to nRT, because v dash, molar volume of the solvent multiplied by number of moles of the solvent, it is equal to total volume of the solution. Okay. Molar volume of the solvent multiplied by number of moles of the solvent, it is equal to total volume. So n into v dash, it is equal to v. So you can see here, we can write here v, pi v equal to nRT, where v is the total volume of the solution. And this equation, it is called as a Wontoff equation. Pi v equal to nRT, it is called as a Wontoff equation here. So in this way, we derive this Wontoff equation. Okay. Now n, it is a number of moles of the solute, and we know that n, it is equal to weight of the solute divided by molecular weight. How we can find out number of moles? W divided by m. So in this case, we have to write n equal to W divided by m. So pi v equal to W upon m into RT. Okay. So we can write here, molecular weight, it is equal to WRT divided by m. So this is another equation we are getting here. Molecular weight, it is equal to WRT divided by pi v, where pi, it is called as osmotic pressure. V is a volume, total volume. W, it is a weight of the solute. R is a constant. Okay. M is the molecular weight of the solute. So in this way, we derive here the Wontoff equation. Okay. So we can derive the Wontoff equation here.